In this tutorial, you will learn how to connect to a multi-dimensional cube using Microsoft Excel. Multi-dimensional cubes are also called OLAP cubes. OLAP stands for Online Analytical Processing. Cubes are created using Microsoft SQL Server Analysis Services and then are navigated and analyzed using Microsoft Excel. Before we can navigate and explore a multi-dimensional cube, we must first connect to the cube. We click on the Data tab in order to connect to a cube. Next, we select the From Other Sources button. In the drop-down menu, we select From Analysis Services. As stated previously, cubes are created in Microsoft SQL Server Analysis Services. To connect to a cube, we must first connect to a data server that contains the desired cube. Note, you must have a remote connection to a data source. Instructions for connecting to a data source using a virtual desktop connection are provided earlier in this online course. In this dialog box, we specify the name of the remote data server that contains our desired cube. The exact server name is included in the same folder as your project number 2, OLAP Business Analytics Lab Assignment. Once the correct server name has been entered, we click Next to continue. On this dialog box, we click the drop-down menu to obtain a list of available cubes. From the drop-down list, we select the AdventureWorks project. We select the one available cube for this project. We click Finish to connect to the AdventureWorks cube. Now that we have connected to the cube, we must import data from the cube. On this dialog box, we select Pivot Chart and Pivot Table Report. We select OK to continue. When the cube data are imported, the Pivot Table field list displays the measures and dimensions that can be used to explore the cube. Measures are shown to the right of a sigma sign. Dimensions are shown to the right of a light blue box. Measures and dimensions are created from data that are contained in a denormalized star schema data warehouse. We will now collapse the internet sales measures to display the available dimensions in this cube. The customer dimension is shown. We will now collapse the customer dimension to reveal more available dimensions in this cube. Now, the due date dimension is displayed. We will collapse the due date dimension. Now, the order date dimension is displayed. Now, the product dimension is displayed. Finally, the last dimension, ship date, is displayed. In order to access more analysis features, we click on the Analyze tab. For example, clicking on the Field List button will hide the Pivot Table field list.
Clicking the button again will restore the pivot table field list.
The pivot chart filter pane is used to filter our analysis. We will hide the pivot chart filter pane for now.
Now that we are familiar with the interface, we can begin to explore our AdventureWorks cube. We will explore this cube in a subsequent video.